Several months ago, we did a small experiment about what would happen if we forgot to remove the cable from charger. You can click the upright corner to check if you haven't seen it. We've received many comments. Some people wonder if it'll affect the other USB ports if we connect the multi-port charger to the wireless charger but don't charge anything. So we'll talk about it today. Let me introduce today's multi-port charger. We've got the Nubia Mini-Amp's 65W GaN charger, Xiaomi 65W GaN charger, UGREEN 65W GaN charger, and MOMAX 100W GaN charger. They're equipped with different USB-A and USB-C ports. Firstly, the Nubia Mini-Amp 65W has dual USB-C ports and supports 65W output, and it'll drop to 45W and 18W when charging two devices. Connected the Apple MagSafe charger to one of the USB-C, the power is about 0.5W, and use it to charge another laptop. The output is only about 41W. Obviously, the wireless charger will affect the charging speed of another device. Switch to the Xiaomi wireless charger. The test result is the same. Next, the Xiaomi 65W GaN charger has a USB-C and a USB-A port. It also supports up to 65W. However, it'll be divided into 45W and 18W when charging two devices. Connect the USB-A port to the Xiaomi wireless charger and continue to charge the laptop with USB-C. And this time, the power is also about 41W, so it'll indeed be affected by the wireless charger. Then replace the Xiaomi wireless charger with Apple MagSafe and continue to charge the Xiaomi 11 Pro with USB-A port. The real-time charging power is only about 15W, which means the output power of USB-A port is not affected. The next charger is the UGREEN 65W GaN charger, equipped with two USB-C and a USB-A ports. The maximum output power is 65W, but it also splits into 45W and 18W when charging two devices. Connect the Apple MagSafe charger to one of the USB-C ports. The standby power is also around 0.5W, and continue to charge the laptop with another USB-C port. And this time, the output power of the other USB-C port is not affected and can maintain above 55W. And then replace the Apple MagSafe with the Xiaomi wireless charger again. The real-time charging power is also above 55W, not affected. Finally, let's take a look at the MOMAX 100W GaN charger. It comes with three USB-C and a USB-A ports. The maximum output power is 100W, and the power will be intelligently distributed when charging multiple devices. We also connected the Xiaomi wireless charger to this charger, and then used another USB-C port to charge the laptop. Our Power-Z tester will reboot. The output is only about 41W, which also be affected. Switch to Apple MagSafe charger. We can see both Power-Z testers will reboot, which means the charging power will be affected. If we remove the wireless charger, the charging power will gradually return to 55W. The wireless charger will be treated as a load for most multi-port chargers. The charger will be adjusted to a multi-port output strategy, even if the wireless charger is actually at no load. However, some chargers, like the UGREEN 65W charger, won't be affected. That's because it has a better distribution strategy. There are also some multi-port output solutions to this issue, but it's still under development. For most multi-port chargers on the market, even a wireless charger with less than 1W will affect its performance. So, we recommend using a separate charger to power the wireless charger until a better solution comes out. Okay, that's all for today's video. And don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye!